from the University of Kentucky, and today I am here in the College of Pharmacy with Dean Dr. Kip Guy. Thank you so much for joining us today.
Glad to join you.
I guess as we start our walk outside the College of Pharmacy, tell me a little bit about what attracted you to the University of Kentucky.
Sure. So I was previously at a large charity hospital focused on pediatric patients. I ran a large research group there developing drugs for children, mostly with cancer. So I'd been out of the university for almost 15 years and started to think about what the next phase of my career would be. I knew I wanted to get back to university. I wanted to keep working in health disparities, which is a major driver for what I do. And I looked around for jobs I thought would be good to do those two things. And Kentucky is an amazing place for doing that kind of work. We have one of the top 10 pharmacy schools in the country, indeed in the world, that's been there ever since we started ranking schools. And we have a lot of very motivated, capable faculty who work on the kinds of problems that interested me. So for me, it was a perfect storm. An ability to teach again, an ability to work with that group of faculty and to do it in an area that had the problems that motivate me to work.
What about the students? Why are they attracted to the UK College of Pharmacy?
Sure, so we have a nice broad range of students who come here, both from Kentucky and from out of state. A good number of them are legacy pharmacists. We have been one of the strongest clinical pharmacy programs for 50 years. So we have many graduates whose kids choose to come back here because their parents came here. And they're often Kentucky natives. We get people who come from all over the world because they know the quality of the college. They want to learn how to do pharmacy the way we do it, which is fully integrated, really intentional, and aimed at making sure the patients get the best medical care they can.
Well, now that we know a little bit more about the students and what attracted you to come here to UK, let's head inside the college and talk a little bit more about the curriculum.
Sure.
So we've made our way upstairs to the patient care lab, correct?
Correct.
Tell me a little bit about what goes on in these spaces and why it's so important.
Sure. So we've just finished a major revision of the PharmD curriculum, which is the primary degree for a pharmacist. And there are a couple underpinning philosophies for that. One of them is that we teach from the perspective of holistic patient care. So when people arrive here nowadays, they meet a patient in their first week. They learn about diagnosis and diagnostic reasoning and clinical reasoning. And then the entire curriculum is taught from that perspective. Another underpinning of it is what's called interprofessional activity. So the idea we work in a team that has medical professionals of all different types. And the third underpinning is that we believe you learn by using your hands. You learn the theory and then you do the theory. And those come together in this space, which is really aimed at teaching the practical aspects of patient care. So a major part of their training is actual externships outside the college in a variety of settings, and those range from private independent pharmacies out in rural areas in Kentucky to large clinics like that across the street. So they can see very high acuity patients, people who are very ill and have very complex diseases. They can meet people who need aspirin, right, and everything in between. That gives the student an opportunity to see how pharmacy is practiced in all those different settings, understand what they want to do, and then re-emphasize that training as they go through the years of the program, and indeed many of them in postgraduate training, to be best prepared for the career they want. So that starts as a summer activity in the middle of school, and by the last year of school, it's essentially all experiential.
Well, what kind of impact does your college have out in the community?
We have impacts at a number of different levels. So I think probably the most fundamental is our graduates practice. Right? And they practice all over the world, but many of them stick in the Commonwealth. We're actually this evening having our formal welcome to the college for our new class, which we call White Coating. And we will have an alumna, Bill Sheely, who built a pharmacy in an elevator shaft inside a clinic because that was the only space available for him to practice in the setting where he wanted to practice. So that kind of story is not at all uncommon among our graduates. You'll meet him at Rite Aid or Kroger or CVS. You'll meet him in the community bluegrass clinic just a mile away from here that has a number of lower-income patients. And you'll meet many of them across the street or in every other hospital you can imagine. I met another pair of alumna, husband and wife, who moved to Jacksonville, Florida about 2 decades ago. When they got there, the pharmacy was in the basement of the hospital. And they exported the Kentucky model. So now their pharmacists practice on the wards. They practice collaboratively with the physicians. Right, so you can see we have impacts everywhere we go.
That's important to you, isn't it? To have that impact in the community.
I think it's the fundamental reason we all do our jobs, right? We want to make sure patients are well taken care of.
Well, thank you so much for showing us around the patient care lab space. I know research is another important aspect of the curriculum and what you do here. So let's head upstairs and take a look at those labs.
Great.
So we've made our way to your research lab, correct?
Yes.
Here in the College of Pharmacy. Tell me a little bit about some of the work that goes on specifically in this lab.
In my lab?
Yes.
So our major focus is on catastrophic diseases where there are not drugs available. And what we try to do is find new starting points to enable putting a drug in the clinic that doesn't exist right now. So one of our major focuses is malaria. 500,000 deaths a year, several hundred million cases a year, but the typical amount of money available to treat a case is a few dollars. There's not a strong commercial driver to get a drug forward into the clinic. I come from a rural agrarian part of the US, and I spent a good bit of my life living in places where there wasn't a lot of money, there wasn't a lot of privilege, and saw the impact of poor access to care. So that became a motivator for me pretty early. So I think one of the things I learned in my life was we don't do anything alone. And when we run into an unusual problem, the bigger the circle of people we have to draw on to think about how to do that problem, the better. So I built a habit of surrounding myself by smart people who came from very different places. And I've continued to try to drive that as a way of working everywhere that I've been, including here at the college. So we look, not only to have diversity of color and diversity of gender, but also diversity of background, age, status, veteran, non-veteran, just about any way you can think about broadening the pool of people who could come to the table to fix something.
As far as your overall kind of research outlook at the college, just generally speaking, what are the types of issues that faculty members here are trying to tackle?
Sure. So the thing that pulls us all together is medications. So in that umbrella, I have everybody from people who focus on very fundamental chemistry, solubility of materials, for example, which affects how they dissolve out of a tablet or how you make an IV solution to administer the drug, all the way over to people who focus on the outcomes, how a drug's used in a population of patients and what happens both positively and negatively to that population. For example, we work in opioid use disorders in the Commonwealth, and we have just brought in an enormous grant as part of a consortium to try to reduce opioid use by 40% in a number of counties in Kentucky. Right, so that's a very different end of the spectrum from what I do, but it all relates back to how medications are used for patients' benefit.
Well, thank you so much for showing us around the College of Pharmacy today. Before we go, is there anything else that you want people to know about your college?
We're the best that there is at what we do. We love to have people in our community as students, as faculty, as staff, who are as dedicated as we are to helping patients.
Thank you so much for showing us around today. If you would like more information on the College of Pharmacy, just visit the link on your screen.